New to Microsoft Teams? Well, in the next 13 minutes, I'm going to show you everything you need to know about the Teams meeting experience for someone who's received a meeting invite from Microsoft Teams and all the things you can do once you're in the meeting. Okay, so basically one of the first things that you'll get if you haven't used Teams before is probably an email that has a Teams meeting invite into it. I happen to be using Outlook in this case, but you could be using something else like Gmail, for example. The main thing is that you need the link to the meeting. So in this case, I'll go ahead and click on this link. And the first thing that you'll see when you join Teams for the very first time is how do you want to open the Teams meeting? So in my case, it does recognize my browser that I have the Teams desktop app installed. If you don't have it installed, you won't see this window here. So I'm gonna go ahead and cancel out of this. And this is probably the view that you'll get if you don't already have the desktop app installed. Now you can go ahead and download the Teams Work or School app. That's basically gonna trigger a download of the app. It will install the app and you'll have to sign in to Microsoft Teams. I've already done this in advance so I can save that time. I'll show that in a second. But I'm gonna go ahead and continue on in the browser because you don't have to have Teams installed in order to use it. There's a great experience directly from the browser. I'm using Edge right here, but you could also be using Google Chrome. Both of them are great experiences, so I'll go ahead and click on continue on this browser. And now here I have basically my camera is already kind of enabled. You can see it's given me a preview. I can disable it if I want to join without the camera on. I can go into custom setup and make sure that all of my speakers are the right devices, my microphone is the right microphone, and the camera, if I have a few different cameras, I can choose the one that I want. So in my case, I will join the meeting, and I'll join the meeting with the microphone muted because I'm actually recording in my screen recording software. So I'll go ahead and turn the camera on, and then I'll go ahead and join the meeting. So now you can see once I join the meeting, I've already got a few people that have joined in with the meeting right now that are sharing their cameras and also sharing their PowerPoint presentation. And because this is a PowerPoint live presentation, the nice thing is with this, I can actually move back and forth between the different slides in this PowerPoint. If I want to, I can go back to where the presenter was presenting. And I've got some really nice controls here from the browser directly. Okay, so now you're probably wondering, well, what does the experience look like if you do join with the desktop app? Well, let's do that right now. Okay, so here I'm actually in the Teams desktop app, and now the way to get to the meetings, and probably one of the better ways to join in general, is to join from your calendar. So I'm gonna go ahead and join this meeting directly from here. Now this is again another pre-join screen, but look, I've got something different going on, which is basically the background filter effects. Now I can go ahead and change these if I want to. I can just make it so it's a background blur. I can also change to a different background if I want. And I have the ability to add another background if I want something completely different. So let's say I want to join from this nice kind of animated room. I can add that then to Microsoft Teams and I've got a different background here. And in the same ways, if I want to, I can change my speaker, my microphone. There are a few other settings though that get enabled for me in the Rich client. So you'll see that I have mirror my video. So some people have asked me actually in comments on some of my previous videos, how do I not mirror the video so that I can see it more or less like other people would see it? Because normally it's like a mirror image of you. So this is my right hand, this is my left hand, and you're basically, if you mirror it, it's the other way around. So this is my right hand, this is my left hand, and you can tell it's mirrored, and that upsets some people. They want to see exactly how others see them on camera. So let me go ahead and unmirror my video in this case, and I can adjust the brightness automatically if I want, and that kind of brightens up my image a little bit. I kind of liked it the way it was, so I'll keep it that way. Soft focus will actually do what it says. It will soften kind of the focus on your skin. Basically, it doesn't really soften the focus on your eyes, so you still look relatively in focus to anybody who's viewing you from the other side of the Teams call. And you can actually adjust how soft the soft focus is, which is kind of nice in the desktop app. So you can kind of turn it down so it's not too noticeable there. And so I'll go ahead and turn down my soft focus a little bit. And now I've got everything more or less set up like I want to. One last setting is noise suppression. So this is really important, especially in for people that are working at home. For example, if you have noise suppression on and maybe you have, you know, a drink or you've got a bag of chips chips or a vacuum cleaner in your house or something like that, the noise suppression will actually cancel out that noise. And it's pretty amazing how well it works. So if there's any abrupt loud noises, it will actually cancel that out and make it so that it's a lot less noticeable and sometimes completely invisible to anybody else who's on the call. So I'm going to go ahead and keep all of these settings here. And now I will join into the call. So now that I'm in the call, you can see that a few others are on the call too. I've got Megan and Alex in their camera. I can see that I have a screen share coming from Megan. I'm gonna go ahead and full screen the meeting. I can go through, this is PowerPoint Live, so I can actually see, you know, what the different presentation slides are in this presentation if I want. I can advance the slide to a different slide on my side only and just kind of flick through and see exactly what different slides are available. If I want to, I can sync back with the presenter. I can also take control if I want. And something that's brand new in Teams is you have the ability to pop out the meeting content. So let's say you're on a slide that has really small text, or you know, maybe you find it difficult to read the text that's under these headings here. So let's say I pop out the meeting content here. In this case, it's PowerPoint Live, so it doesn't quite give me the full screen, but it gives me a nice view that I can use. And if I want to go even slightly larger than this, I can hit F11. And I can see almost a full screen view of this slide. And as the presenter presents and moves around the slide deck, you'll see that, you know, all of those transitions and everything that they're doing is exactly how it's intended from the presenter's standpoint. So now let me go ahead and go back out of full screen. Now, once I, from the pop-out window view, close it, it will actually snap it back into Microsoft Teams. There we go. So now it's snapped back into Microsoft Teams. So now when you're in the call, let me point out some other really important functionality while I'm here. So you can see that we have a couple of people that are already in the call. So we have Alex and Megan in the call and others who are invited. Something else I can do as well is I can go into the chat, and if I want to chat, I can say, great presentation, and I can send, you know, different emojis. So here, if I do this, I can go ahead and pick the emoji that I want and send it. It's Teams, so I can also do other things like do some of the GIFs as well. So if I want to send any other materials through the chat, I can do that too, and as well as use stickers. Now, the great thing is from the other side, if they actually go in, the presenter, for example, if they want to, they can actually like my reply with a heart. Now, the other way that we can show live reactions if we want to during the meetings is that I can basically go in and use the reactions button. And for example, if I have a question, so that the presenter, if it's the teacher, the professor, the meeting owner, can actually acknowledge that I've got my hand raised and want to ask a question, I can go ahead and do that. So I can also unraise my hand if I've had my question answered. I can also give praise or likes or other things during the call. So maybe people are asking me if they like the idea and the concept and everything that gets presented. I can do that. I can give various applause or other emotions. Okay, so now one more thing I can do actually is I can go into the More menu, and you can see there are a bunch of different options here. So one of the things that I like to use, because I'm capturing a lot of video, sometimes remote video from folks, is look at the call health. Now, the call health is nice because it will say, you know, what my frame rate looks like that I'm sending, latency, etc., is part of this. If I go back into the More menu, something else I can do is I can start up meeting notes if I want. Now, this is going to basically take notes against the meeting so that you have kind of a OneNote file that's being captured against the meeting. So if you want to take some actions, and you can say, and so we're taking notes there, and we can basically use this as follow-up. And this is being stored basically in OneNote against the meeting. I'll go back to the meeting. Some other capabilities that you can do in the call. So one thing that's super cool is the ability to change the gallery location. If I want to put the gallery on top, I can move the other tiles to the top. And this actually makes it easier to be able to see my own camera feed right in the corner here, so that I'm not looking, you know, really far down into the presentation or really far up. Another thing I can do here beyond just changing where the gallery is, if I want to focus on content, if I just want to preview what my camera looks like, and I can also do full screen, which is basically giving me about the same size as before. If somebody's sharing a desktop content, you can see actually a full screen without even this bar of content up top, but this gives me a nice larger view if I want it. Now, here's where our background effects were. If I want to change them during the call, I can go ahead and, you know, flip it if I want to just background blur. And if I hit apply, that's going to change my background to just background blur, or I can go ahead and turn off my background here. So I'll go ahead and do that in this case. And I can change in terms of any of the background effects that I have turned on. Now, something else that I can do, and I'll go ahead and try this, turn on live captions. I have multiple different calls running. So let's see how this goes. So I'm going to actually record my voice so you can see it in the transcription. But this is going to basically transcribe in real time what anyone says. And you can see that it's got my name next to it, and you can see exactly the attribution of who spoke based on the microphone that was active at the time someone spoke. The other thing I can do is I can actually record the call. So if I want to record the meeting, I hit the record button. This is going to actually record the meeting, and it's going to record it for the person who presses record. It will record into their stream content, their recordings folder, and basically their OneDrive. Now, let's say, you know, you want to stop recording. So you want to go off the official record of the call. You can stop recording and continue the call with other people, you know, while still active in the meeting window. So there are a couple other controls just in terms of reducing the, you know, noisiness of what's on screen. You can say don't show the chat bubbles, so the things that are popping up in the corner. You can mute notifications during the meeting as well, so that can be distracting also. And if you want to turn off incoming video, now this is actually pretty important. For example, if you want to save bandwidth, so the nice thing is you can, if you want to, turn off incoming video. So let's say if I go out of focus on content, you can see that now Megan and Alex's video has been turned off. And of course I can, if I want to, turn back on incoming video, and that will re-enable their video so that you can see what's coming in. So one last thing before I go though is if you want to share content, when you share screen, you're effectively kicking the other person out who was sharing their content to you. So that means that you will have stopped their sharing session. So one thing to note there is if you want to go back to their screen, you'll need to ask them to reshare. This time I'll configure standout mode, and I'm going to share a Word document that I have on another monitor. And when I do that, you'll see that it gives me a nice preview of exactly what it looks like to other people. And the nice thing is I can change the size of me, so I can actually make it so I'm not consuming as much space on the document. I can also flip it to the other side if I want to, maybe not block any content in the document that's important. So this document's actually on another screen, so I can interact with it if I want. And as I scroll down, you'll notice that in my case, the audience can see me just in one corner of the screen. So I have a nice kind of sharing experience where I can still stay engaged with the audience that I have in the call while I share my presentation or my Word document. And then to end the call, all you have to do is hit the leave button, and that's it. So now you should have everything you need to know about Microsoft Teams meetings. If you like this video and got value from it, be sure to hit the like button, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and as always, thank you for watching.